And we are back in action here, guys. We've got Ben Johns back out there with Joey Farias. Got Eddie and Scott Golden on the microphones here.
Awesome. So Frank was going to do another one with us, but he actually had a little issue there, so he had to go talk with some folks. But thanks for joining me, Eddie.
My pleasure. Thanks for joining me. We're trying to move these matches along because, as you can tell, it's pretty late at night, and you know, I'm sure people want to get home. So,
yes, they do. And honestly, we'd like to get some sleep tonight too.
Yeah,
so
it's gonna be another long day tomorrow, with another long day after that, and another long day after that. But man, these long days are incredibly fun. So.
They are.
I'm not saying it in a bad way whatsoever.
No, I mean, but the truth is, they're just long days.
Yep.
That's a good play right there. All right, 3-2. Boy, I tell you what, there's some energy in this game right here. Joey's coming out slinging. Well, you have to against a guy like Ben Johns, I suppose. Oh, he's got to hit that. He hits that on a regular basis. All right, it's 5-4. Ooh, that's a rare miss serve by Ben Johns there. Joey's not going to give him the ball back, though. He's going to take the point and the side out. All right, 5-5. Nice deep serve by Joey there. All right, got a change of momentum here. All of a sudden, 6-5. Actually, 6-5 Joey. Now 6-6.
I thought that last one there was long, but
oh yeah, he actually hit a winner.
Yeah,
I was surprised.
I was surprised by that. Yeah.
All right, 7-6. A little frustration there by Joey. I think the ball did something that he didn't want it to do. It didn't cooperate with him right there on that point. Because sometimes you can tell when the pros, like, something happens. They don't just normally shank a ball, typically. They usually hit pretty solid stuff. So sometimes the ball will do something funky or the it comes off the court kind of weird, and they'll kind of look at the ground, or they'll look at the paddle, or they'll look at the ball. Like, because, I mean, in all honesty, the average player does that a lot, but it's probably the operator, not the other circumstances. But in the pro division, sometimes it is something funky that happens, and you'll just see them kind of show some frustration because they're not used to missing that. They're accustomed to hitting the ball solid, and so I think that's what happened there with Joey. All right, 8-6. Back and forth seesaw match so far. Boy, I tell you what. Joey's getting some nasty movement on that ball. All right, 7-8. All right, 8-8. I'm sorry, 9-7. He said seven. The ref said 7-9, but it's actually 9-7, I believe. Yeah, I believe it's 10-7 now. So just if you're listening, I think he confused that, but it's actually the score's right. It's Ben John's 10, Joey 7. Yeah, Joey knew. Joey actually said yep before the ball even hit the ground. That's when you know you're playing the number one player in the world.
That's
when
right.
You see him hit the ball and you go yep before it even touches the ground. That's just too good by Ben. Very competitive game in the first game won. 11-7, Ben. We're going to switch sides, let him do it again. I got to tell you, Eddie, I'm the commentator and you're the commentator over here, but I like this rally scoring because the games don't – there's no, like, long-winded games.
They're really moving, man.
It's moving. Like 5 to 7 minutes at the most.
Mm-hmm.
Like probably 5 minutes.
Yep. They're getting these matches moving, which I definitely like.
Yeah, for our benefit too, because we had the 3-hour rain delay. It's good that the rally scoring is what we're doing today.
Mm-hmm.
Because you know we may not have rain the rest of the weekend.
Right.
I don't know. I'm not gonna say either way. But my point is, if we're gonna have rain, I'd rather be on the day where we're doing singles with rally scoring.
I agree. Here we go. Time in. Ben John's taking game one, 11-7 against Joey Farias.
Farias. Jose. It's actually on the thing. It's Jose Farias. I guess they made the decision. So we started out, just to give everybody perspective here, we started out the day hoping to get going at 8 a.m. At 7:58, there was no rain in sight. At exactly 8 o'clock on the money, it started to rain. It then proceeded back and forth for 3 hours on a delay. Till finally we get started at 11. So the original format was to play everything up to the semifinals today, and then Monday play just the finals. Well, then, halfway through the day, they made the call to just do up to the quarterfinals. And then play semifinals and finals at the end. And now they've made the decision, because it's so late, that we're going to just wait on any of the bracket play until Monday and just do the rest of the pool play here. All right, so Ben John's taking an early lead here in game two. Seems to be in control at 5-1. Joey just made that one look really easy. He's just like, you know what? No. All right, 2-5. It's to the point of what... Frank Anthony Davis was saying earlier is like these games, the rally scoring makes the game feel closer than maybe what it actually is sometimes, because you can score points when you're not serving. So like you might be down 5-2, but if you win that next point, it's 3-5 and you got the ball serving. So it really does. The longer I've watched this all day today, it really does dilute the serve. And by that, I mean, you don't have a distinct advantage anymore when you're the one serving. like where you do in traditional format. You just have to play hard each point. And that's why you see these guys battling and hustling and running around trying to get to every ball, even if they're not serving, because it counts and matters, you know? And it makes for, honestly, I think it makes for better play each point because guys don't give up on the ball. Except for if there's a pole in the way like that. Ben had to give up a little bit on that one. I don't think he wanted to, but it was that or hit the pole with his face. All right, Joey making a push here. It's 4-7. Feels like an uphill battle, I'm sure, against Ben Johns down three, but it's really just 3 points. So, and now it's 2 points. So it's 5-7. Joey making a strong push here in game two. Oh, I like that, but didn't work against Ben. It's 8-5. Ben up in game two. Ben took game one 11-7, as you can see. All right, 9-5. You see Joey give Ben the respect there. That's just a true professional, I think, because he just basically said, too good, you know, too good. It's just not going to be able to do anything about that. All right, 6-9. Joey's able to keep it within 2-3. He's hanging around that 2-3 range, being down. So he's really got to make a strong push right here. He's brought it within 2. Oh man, I mean, how in the world does Ben Johns anticipate where that ball's gonna be? 10-7. All right, that's a wrap. That was two highly competitive matches. Even though the score came out in the favor of Ben Johns, Joey was no pushover there. That was an absolute fun two games to watch.